We are going through this concrete mathematics book, Graham, Knuth, and Patashnik, and they have these different methods for solving, basically taking something that you have as a summation or anything else really, and solving it in closed form. So we've already gone through, well, three of the methods, because the first one was method zero, because we're looking it up and apparently indexing at zero. But anyway, we're now looking at method three, which is the repertoire method. So we are going to build a repertoire. And in order to do this, we need to rewrite this as a recursive function. So that's not too bad. We've talked about this in other videos, that we can take something that is a summation and rewrite it in recursive form. Ow! Which basically means that we're just going to take, we're going to pull off the top term. So just make that n minus 1 and then put the n squared kind of off by itself. I don't want to put that in parentheses, but plus n squared. And then we can recognize that this is just box of n minus 1. So we have box of n is equal to box of n minus 1 plus n squared. So now we have it as a recursive function, which is good. We also need to write a base case, so we know that base or box of 0 is going to be just 0. Now, in other videos, we've already established a repertoire. And so there that is. So these are things that we've already established. We know that they work, and now we just need to apply them to our current problem. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to let box sub n equals to alpha a sub n beta b sub n and gamma c sub n. And again, if you didn't watch the videos on repertoire, you'll be totally lost. So that's a whole other like multi-step lecture. So you should go check that out. So we know that that is equal to that. So that means that the n minus 1 term would also be basically the same thing, but with an n minus 1 term on it, c sub n minus 1 like that. All right, so we can go ahead, and everywhere we see an a sub n, we can plug in the recursive definition. So we've got 3n squared minus 3n plus 1 plus a sub n minus 1. Ooh, that was funny. N minus 1, and then beta, 2n minus 1 plus b sub n minus 1, and then gamma 1 plus c sub n minus 1. And let me just kind of play around with that for a while. I'm going to combine the terms. So I have 3 alpha n squared, and then I combine the n terms. So we've got negative 3 alpha n plus 2 beta n, or sorry, alpha and then 2 beta n. There we go. 2 beta n. And then alpha minus beta plus gamma, that's your constant term. And then we have all the other recursive-y parts of the thing over here. All right, so this we recognize, oops, this here we recognize that's gonna be the n minus one term, so that's the recursive term. So that means that we have, I'm just gonna rewrite this right here, like that. And if we kind of come back here and look, we see that the recursive function should be this, which is just the plus n squared. So our goal is to make it match this is equal to n squared plus this n minus 1. So basically there's a 0 in front of the n and there's a 0 for the constant term. So you can come in here and say, okay, so 3 alpha is going to be 1. Negative 3 alpha and 2 beta is going to be 0. So beta is 1/2, and alpha minus beta plus gamma is also going to be equal to 0. So that means that gamma is going to be equal to 1/6. Awesome. Now we're going to take the ways that we know to convert the recursive definitions into the closed forms, and we're going to apply this as well. So since we know that we have this, I just rewrote what we already had up there. And I have values for all these. So alpha is 1/3, an is this n cubed. So an is n cubed and then n squared and n. So I have to keep scrolling up. So I have 1/3 n cubed plus 1/2 n squared plus 1/6 n. So actually that is a closed form. I could actually quit there, but if we want to kind of show that we're getting the same thing that we got all the other times, I can do that. Once you know how to do repertoire, it's actually pretty quick. So let's put everything over 6. 2n squared plus 3n squared plus n over 6. And this is actually one that we had already done. So 2n squared, 3n plus 1. And we just have to factor it out one more time. 2n plus 1 times n plus 1 over, I put 2, it's supposed to be a 6, over 6. And actually, that's the same answer we've gotten now apparently 4 other times or 3 other times, just by just a totally different method. So again, the idea is if you are stuck with some kind of thing that you don't know how to write in closed form, we're just going through all kinds of different ways that you can go ahead and figure that out.